Welcome back. In this video, we are going to take a deep look into Semrush's on-page SEO checker. This is a tool which helps you to check on-page SEO for a certain keyword. This helps you to do that in bulk. We have already taken a look into site audit, which checks for general SEO errors and errors in your website, general errors. And this particular tool will compare your site SEO from an on-page SEO for a target keyword. In order to get access to this tool, you come into Semrush and under on-page and tech SEO, you can see on-page SEO checker. Basically, you create a project and you can see I have already created a project which I haven't set up any on-page SEO checker. In this example, I'm going to do for that particular website. I just need to click on setup and I set a target country for me. In this case, no, it's not United States. I'm selecting a local country. And from that, I can select a region or city, or I can set it as a country level. I choose the device which I'm interested on and click on crawl user agent. And yeah, I can select maybe Semrush bot or Google bot. As a personal preference, I like to use Google bot. And I can set a schedule whether I want to do this process weekly or just never. I just want to do it once or something like that. So depending on my need, I can select it. And if we come back to the page one, you can see I like selected Sri Lanka and clicked on continue. And automatically it will try to import keywords. Like it automatically will try to bring keywords from several sources, such as organic research within Semrush, position tracking within Semrush. So depending on that, it will try to bring some keywords for me if I'm interested on. So I can select something, I can delete if something is not interested for me, something like this. Maybe that is suited for me. So I can bring some keyword from manually also, or I can from CSV import it from here, or I can connect my Google Search Console and bring keywords and URLs from there. Or I can use Google Semrush organic search to bring data for me. So whichever the option is useful for me, I select it and click just on collect ideas. And automatically it will start to do a bulk checking on-page SEO for all the target keywords which I presented. You can see it is already started analyzing and currently 4 key pages left. Let me wait until this finishes first. Okay, the on-page SEO checker has finished checking. Basically, it found 32 keywords for 4 pages and it automatically giving me several suggestions. Basically, the on-page SEO checker within Semrush is divided into 4 different categories. Basic overview will give you overall a summary. And basically, when you go into one of these stuff, it will give you much more in-depth information. So it gives me 4 strategy ideas is available for me, 4 backlink ideas is available for me. I can connect my Google Analytics to get user experience idea, technical SEO ideas, SERP feature ideas, semantic ideas, content ideas. When you hover over any of these things, you can see Semrush also gives you a good explanation on what each of this idea means. And I can click on any of this a number count and it will take me to that idea specifically. And basically you can see a basic currently I'm getting 250, but with the potential of 11.1k and that their ideas can increase. Basically that is a basic improvement explanation. And it's giving me a sample summary. I can click on here. It will take to this particular optimization idea section to give all the ideas and gives me all the URLs. So rather than checking it here, let me go into optimization ideas. And within here, it's saying that this is the top priority URL for me. I need to look into this because it has the potential to bring around 26,000 traffic. And if I click on the 9 ideas, it will give me ideas on that. For example, there is no strategy idea for this particular page. There is a SERP idea. For example, mark up your aggregate rating. You can may increase that. I should mark up my code. So it's saying that based on my top 10 ranking rivals data, I should mark up my aggregate rating. Why should I do that? When I do that, it's saying me like why I need to do that. So doing that, it gives me an example with the difficulty. If you know how to do it, you can do it, or you can do a Google search on saying like something like mark up your aggregate rating in WordPress or some other HTML, or you can hire a developer to do that for you. Then we have content ideas, like avoid keyword stuffing in your body tags. Like compared to your rival, these keywords are repeated on your body tag too many times. So I want to avoid this particular keyword. So it's saying this is very difficult, very easy compared to the other one. When I click on see detailed, it will give me a detailed analysis on the data with all the rivals section. All the data are shown here. You can see it has done a full in-depth analysis on that section as here. And you can see the basic information is presented here. So depending on that, it has avoid keyword stuffing, focus on creating more informative content. And you can see why should I do that. And when I click on it, it says that I'm only covering this amount of words compared to my rival. Some of my rivals having a lot more content length. So that is also an example. Going back, I can see another one like make your tech and content more readable compared to rival. Your content is very difficult to read. So it gives me an analysis on that as well. You can see readability. This is my readability where others are having very good readability and I might not have that. So based on that, I need to improve the readability, provide more relevant meta description, provide more relevant title. All this data have a show more or either see detailed analysis to give more data for me. And these are good ones and these I need to include within my body section. So it gives me a detailed analysis section here. Then we have semantic ideas, what I need to do in on page. With semantic idea, enrich your page content. I need to create more content covering these kind of keyword also. If it's suited to me, I need to do that also. And backlinks, like I need to try to earn backlinks from these sources because most of my competitors may be receiving a backlink from here. So I also need to do that as well. Technical SEO is perfect. User experience, I need to connect Google Analytics account. So that is how we can go in depth into different ideas and fix those issues to get more on-page SEO benefits. Then we go into top 10 benchmarking. Here it will give you overall analysis, SERP analysis for target keyword. For example, this particular marriage proposal keyword has a 3.6K volume. I'm not currently ranking on it. And you can see it gives me an overall summary on how different criteria are happening within the top 10 ranking pages. And if I click on view full analysis, it will give you a full analysis. For example, this particular keyword is receiving this amount of traffic. Currently, the top 10 average keyword is just around 290. Your page has 298. Referring domain, how many domains should have, video usage, keyword usage, ordered list, markup list, readability, all these data are shown here with the top 10 ranking also with number 100, which I'm ranking below 100. So within that also, I can get an idea on how each for all the different keyword, how we are ranking also. So that is what top 10 benchmarking does. And finally, idea task. Idea task is where you can basically see different ideas are given. For all the optimization idea, a task can be created. And it's saying that from a semantic category, for this page, I need to enrich my page content for this particular keyword and 12 more. So it has created a to-do and I can start doing it basically. You can also see it is currently collecting more data. So as the data goes by, this idea task will also keep on getting improved. So this is showing me all the data and what are the things I need to do. So you can see all the different ideas on relating to improve on-page SEO.